what you see now with Westlife, it's probably more real than it's ever been.
Bouncing around the stage and looking over and kind of laughing at the other lads. We feed off the crowd all the time and they definitely come alive as well.
We're in a good place as a band, we're very strong, we're very focused on the future.
This is part of our life right now, this is what's going on.
Today is the photo shoot for the tour program with none other than Kevin McDade and the fiance of Mr. Mark Patrick Fihili. And it's taken the whole theme of the tour to a new level because the theme of the tour this year is the apocalypse. So when you're at the show and then you've got the program, it kind of all matches in and makes sense.
Best thing to be a good model is to be relaxed, Mark.
Mark's not a model today, he's the creative director.
Mark is the complete art director for the tour program this year, which is very exciting. Mark is a very, very, very creative person and always has been, you know, since I've known him since he was a kid. Obviously, Kevin being the photographer, you know, him and Mark have worked very closely together to make all this happen. You know, it's great to see. It's great to see the enthusiasm and it's great to see that he's really enjoying it, which is, you know, what it's all about.
It was kind of like a pressure that I welcomed it, you know. The idea of putting a photo shoot together 2 or 3 years ago, I would have not been very confident to do it. I think we've all grown up a lot in that way, and I'm like lots of other people do it, so, you know, just get on with it.
Happy?
Very happy.
Excellent. Anyone get clean?
Happy days?
I think the year off has done an awful lot for us. I think it gave us the break that we badly needed as a band, mentally, physically, everything. I think now as well we're kind of looking forward to the future. You know, we've obviously, we're talking about doing an album this year, and then, you know, after that it's we kind of take it 1 year at a time. It's very hard to, you know, you can't keep doing it like 9 albums in a row.
That's against protocol.
Okay, he's totally getting in character, Nick.
Last year was a strange year, to be quite honest. We were due to fly to LA, and then Keane's dad passed away. And as you can imagine, that was a tough time. So we knocked everything on the head, obviously, and we took a bit of, you know, another month or 6 weeks away. And then we eventually went to America, I think the end of August or September, did the album, got in the bag. And everything was just starting, and then my dad died on November 3rd. And that kind of threw everything, you know. I knew my dad and then Keane's dad being the same, we wouldn't want it any other way, but to get, you know, to keep working. But I think we're ready to go back out on tour now, which will have been nearly 2 years, or it will have been 2 years, since we've last been on stage. And going back on what I was talking about earlier with the two dads dying, you kind of grow up, you've no choice but to grow up.
Mornings after, it still lingers. Just waking up, I see a shadow of you. Making breakfast for two.
Yeah, I definitely think the year off, in a sense, was a big eye-opener for us all. Being away from Westlife for a year is always going to make you miss it and make you realise what you have. You know, the year off was a strange time for me in a sense. You know, I got married. My dad passed away. I ended up managing a new band, so I didn't really feel like I had a year off as such. But I certainly had a year off from Westlife, and I certainly had a year away from Westlife. And I think, you know, coming back to make this album, we were a lot more enthusiastic about it.
Just a few fans, isn't it? Just a couple.
Hello.
Will we be still around in 5 years? I think so, and I hope so. But it all comes down to the album success. And you know, just having that break is very important. Like every couple of years, we will need to take a year off, or we will need to, because we've got families, got different things going on now.
Enjoy the stage. Just enjoy it.
It's so good up there. There's wind and
road. No fear at all. No nerves or nothing.
There's other kind of projects people are doing. There's stuff going on in our life, and it's Westlife is the most important thing, obviously. You know, but there's other little things we like to do too, and it's nice to be able to do both.
Say, what's the story?
Blessing raise me up.
Okay, you go.
Yeah.
You raise me up,
so I
the obvious black and white part of it is we're 12 years in. We've actually, as a band, found ourselves.
I think all in all, we've all matured. We all know what makes us all tick, what makes us not tick. None of us wanted to end. I really, really, really believe that. I'm not saying that, you know, you can, like, you know, do it at the same pace forever. But I think it's also a level of maturity where you can actually sit down and say, right, this is how we need to work it.
When everything is war, you're living in a battle zone.
Hello. This is the production team, y'all. I've got America for the day. She's better, she's alive, which is the most important thing.
I think it's quite a natural progression for people like who've been in the business for a certain amount of time to slowly get confidence in areas they wouldn't have had confidence in before and stuff like that. Now we're kind of just going, you know, bring it on, like, you know, we're growing up, you know, it's time to be adults and get on with it. And I suppose we're always wanting to learn more. Like, if you look at Cian, kind of, you know, he's managing a girl band now, whereas 3 years ago he kind of was getting into the idea of, right, I think I could manage a band. Everyone's moving on and upwards, and everyone enjoys Westlife more because they get to do those other things as well.
I was just starting the audience there in the sound desk, watching my girl band, my support act, and I was like that, and not one person recognised me. It's great. Here they come now, this is Wonderland.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi,
how are you?
We're sweating, can we just come on?
Everyone be like, God, what's wrong with them?
Such a sweaty girl band.
I think it's the most people ever in the O2 tonight. We're on the stage, there's people actually back there, behind the stage, which doesn't seem fair, but they said they want to be close to us, they don't want to see us. So best of luck, you know, it's all good.
So far the reaction has been probably the best reaction we've had in a few tours, I'd say. So far, everyone is saying it's the best show we have, Louis as well, so he'll always tell us straight up if it's better than last year or not, you know.
There's a bit of a surprise tonight because it's Gillian's birthday tomorrow. So I didn't say anything, I just said, no, don't worry, we won't celebrate it, we won't do anything at all, you know. And I've got our best friend's flown over as a surprise. Just a wee bit of a surprise here. She hasn't got a clue, she's about to come here, she's thinking, oh, I'm on my own tonight, who will I sit with? But little does she know, I've been doing something to you now. So she's going to be very excited. So, happy birthday, Gillian. You deserve it, babe.
Come inside, to my dressing room. This particular show, it's straight to hell, I think, of any other shows we've done. Visually, it's amazing. It's like a real show. It's kind of built around what Westlife is and what we are, and then obviously put us up there, that's when the magic happens, you know. You've got this amazing set, and then you put us, you know, together with all that, and it just becomes what it is.
I think this tour is definitely different to what we've done before. We've kind of eliminated a lot of the kind of, shall we say, boy band tricks, like popping out of the floor, coming down from the ceiling, all that type of stuff. And we've kind of concentrated a lot more on the musical side of it and a lot more on the visual side of it. Going back on stage and just seeing the reaction from an audience again, and seeing an audience kind of screaming at you and screaming your songs at you and stuff like that, I mean, there's no other feeling like it. This tour has definitely kind of shook us up and gone, wow, like, look at what we actually have here, look at what we can have.
I think my favourite part of the show to perform, I think it's very hard to get past the medley in terms of enjoyment level, you know, the crowd going crazy, and on top of that, like, you know, performing songs we don't normally perform. It's definitely the most exciting part of the show all around.
This year was different again. It was all up to modern music, up to date music, and Westlife doing Halo, you go, you're losing your mind. Westlife doing the Black Eyed Peas, I'm enjoying it this year, you know, and I think we all get to shine that little bit more this year.
I see you again and you raise me up together. It's kind of a sad ending, but in a way it shows that we're normal human beings, you know, and we have parents, and two of the lads have lost their dads in the last year, and it brings out the kind of natural people that's in us, you know, we have feelings too, you know.
The end two songs, well, mainly I'll See You Again, obviously they're based on myself and Nikki losing our dads this year. You know, for me, it was kind of like when we spoke about doing it, I was kind of like, oh, I don't know, is it the right thing, is it the wrong thing? And then I thought, you know what, like, our dads would have been so proud to kind of see that, and kind of like, you know, I know it's very hard. I mean, I personally haven't looked around behind the screens yet. I've noticed Nikki do it a few times, but I personally deliberately am not turning my head to look back in them screens and see a picture of my dad on the screen, because I know it's just going to get me. And then with You Raise Me Up, that's also the song that we sang at my dad's funeral and at Nikki's dad's funeral. So obviously that actually probably has more of meaning to us personally than say I'll See You Again. So on the first night I got really choked in that song, and I just kind of had to put my microphone down for a second and take a deep breath and stop. But you know, I think it's all relevant to our life, because this is what's happened.
I'll see you again.
You know, thankfully myself and G were, you know, have two healthy little kids, and they're at the age now where they know what's going on, you know. And I've seen them from the stage, but obviously when I'm on stage I can't physically be that close to them. You know, and they're wearing these things in the show, and they're looking at daddy, and they're trying to sing and they're pretending to mime, and she said Jay is like squinting his eyes, and he's like, and he's not actually physically saying anything or singing anything, but he's obviously seen me on camera, and he must be trying to copy my pose. And
happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Can you just pour his
Happy birthday, babe.
Your husband organized it.
Not bad, Jennifer.
Looking forward to the show. We're not long away now. We've 35 minutes before we're ready. I feel a little bit like Manny Pacquiao or Ricky Hatton or something at the moment, because I'm live in Sky Box Office. Because usually it's me in my house going, Sky Box, will I get that fight? Yeah, I think I'll get that fight. So all you people are probably in that position now going, Tommy, will I buy the fight? Will I buy the concert? Like, nah, don't buy Westlife. They're bleeding crap.
It's all right, lads. I'm here. Don't worry. Show can still go on. You know what I mean? The main man is here. It's all done.
Da 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 da
da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da
da da
da da da da da da da da da da da da I'm ready. Are you ready? Are you ready for love? Yes, I am. Oh, yeah.
I think we all have to sit down as four individuals, but sit down as a group and find out what we all want individually. I think as a band, we are strong, but it's a marathon, not a sprint. And, you know, for us anymore, it is a marathon, you know.
I can't wait to get back into the studio again, whether it's to write or just record other people's songs. You know, it's my favourite place in the world to be in the studio for hours on end.
I think now we're definitely on top of everything, and we're definitely on top of it, so much so that you can always sit down and try and achieve the greatness that you strive for.
I don't see any reason why it needs to end. We've just got to be who we are. And I think that's really why it works, because we're all into what we're doing. We're all feeling it a massive amount. You know, there's that buzz again, there is. And it feels great. Now where we are.